Is it shampoo? Joe, look at me. The shampoo smells quite nice.
Whenever I start these vlogs, I just look at my barnet and just think, what am I doing? Why is it still in my hair? Good point, why is it still in my hair? And two, it is Christmassy, it is Vlogmas, so maybe that's why I've kept it festive looking and red. Anyway, regardless, here we go, another vlog. Enjoy.
It's Thatcher Joe's Vlogmas. But remember, he's not a daily vlogger.
Ah, what an intro. Also, thanks for sending in all your edits for these intros, by the way. One thing I must point out, though, a lot of you are sending them in, like, portrait or, like, square. You've got to realise, because this the way the screen is on your phone or computer right now, it's got to be this kind of shape. So the shape that you're watching this right now, it's got to be a landscape kind of shape for it to sort of really work. If you are making them, thank you so much. I do see all of them, and I love and appreciate all of them, so you guys are amazing. I had a lovely sleep last night. Although, saying that, this bed... even just go jump on it, as you can see, it's on wheels, so it slides around a lot. So I was thinking I'm gonna end up waking up all the way down there or something in the middle of the night. The weather this morning is looking pretty grim. And this is where we were last night in the hot tub here, and we thought we could hear someone out there walking around. I don't think there would have been anyone down there. Lovely day here down at the glen. Now I've actually booked in a massage today for Diane and myself, because, you know, still, not gonna lie, still aching. Saturday's performance was a big one. As you can see, we did the Charleston, the show dance, and a Paso. Three very quite intense physical dances. So, as you can imagine, we're still aching quite a lot. So we're gonna go and have a massage at 2:30 today. Before that, we've got a bit of time to kill. It's still in like 10 a.m. We've had breakfast. We're all just in the lounge now. We're gonna maybe walk down to the beach. Apparently there's a beach near here, and I haven't been to the beach in a long time. Definitely not gonna go in the sea, because that would be very, very dangerous, as it is currently probably like 5 degrees outside, and the sea would be a lot colder. But in saying that, I do wanna go down to the beach and just see what it's like, because I haven't seen the sea in a long time, and we're very close. Living in London, as you can imagine, you don't get to see the sea that often, so let's do that. One thing I want to lightly touch on as well, just like my thoughts on a certain situation, is of course at the moment, as you can imagine, the press and, you know, news outlets are very, very interested in finding out about what I get to do in my life and what's going on with my life and my business. You know, they want to know my business, which, thinking about it, it's completely, you know, I understand that they're doing their job. Everyone's got to provide for their families and do their job and get paid. That's how life works. So I completely understand and appreciate that, you know, that's part of their job and they've got to do that. I completely understand that part of it. But the one part of it all that does upset me a little bit, and has, I don't know, it's disappointed me a little bit, is the fact that some journalists are pretending to be neighbours or just general people in the local area and going to my 95-year-old nan's house, knocking on our door, trying to get any information they can about me and people in my life. It is quite annoying. Finding out about that obviously has upset me a little bit. I just don't understand how some people basically have gone to university for years to study a degree in journalism, to then find themselves a few years later going to someone's 95-year-old nan's house, knocking on their door, probably being very manipulative in the way they get information out, and basically taking advantage of an elderly person for their own gain, for a paper's gain or for a news outlet's gain. And, you know, it has upset me a little bit. I think it's very disrespectful. But once again, you know, I understand that they've got a do their job, but I think that, you know, morally I just don't think that's right. And, you know, to hear that news, especially after being followed almost all the way here by a paparazzi in his car, to the point where it was, you know, it was freaking me out. I saw this guy straight away. I know that he sits in private property all day waiting illegally to get a photograph of me leaving my house or whatever. But once again, like I said, I totally understand it, doing his job. But when it's the point where you leave your house and he follows you almost all the way here, to the point where I have to drive off the motorway and hide in someone else's driveway for him to pass and then quickly speed off. It was like a real life James Bond moment, I'm not gonna lie. You know, it is scary. I'm not used to this. The thing is, well, I'm a YouTuber, I'm a vlogger. What I do as a career is share my life with the people on over the internet. Do you know what I mean? So, like, I don't understand what they're trying to get. I'm showing my life anyway. I don't really understand how my career and the press really goes together, if that makes sense. I kind of am my own news outlet. I supply you guys with my own news myself. So I'm starting to understand why they waste their time following me around when, you know, they don't need to, because whatever they're trying to get, I'm pretty much posting out on here anyway. Don't understand it. But one, you know, it was dangerous what happened yesterday. Just knowing you've got a car up your ass the whole way, you know, it puts you on edge. As you can imagine, I know this car, I've seen this car all the time following me around, and, you know, it does put you on edge. He's right up your ass the whole time trying to get photographs whilst driving, which is dangerous in itself, and it puts me on edge. I can't concentrate as well when I know that someone is following me all day long. And then to get here and hear about people knocking on my door, my nan's door, it is just it's just disrespectful a little bit. Once again though, I do understand that it's their job, they're just doing their job, everyone's got to have a career. It's just a little bit a little bit of a Debbie Downer to start the morning off. But you know, not gonna let it bother us. We're here to relax, we're here to have fun, and that is the whole reason why we've come here, is to kind of get away from it all just for a couple of days, be in control of what we put out ourselves, and just have fun. But also, still, you know, make videos so you guys can still enjoy it all with us. Anyway, rant, I guess, kind of over. Sort of rant, I don't know, but yeah. Let's crack on with the day.
Also, we had this big box of like breakfast food all arrive like first thing this morning. They come in through this door here. They leave it in the hatch underneath there or the outside the door here. So this morning I walked over, discovered this hamper full of goodies. Still haven't had our fruit yet. But I'll show you through here into the lounge. See who's awake.
I'm awake.
Oh, look who's awake. This is a trip hazard. What are you trying to do, kill me?
Yeah,
it's my holiday. It's my only 2 days off of the year and you're trying to kill me? But look at all this. We've got toast. We've got pastries. We've got, what's this stuff called?
Porridge muesli.
No, what are you, your special name for?
Oh, bircher muesli.
Bircher muesli, birch food.
Birch feed.
I've had a coffee and a tea and an orange. I've never had so many liquids.
You're gonna be shaking like a leaf.
I was gonna say, you're gonna be shitting out your ass.
That too.
I think we should go to the beach. What do you think?
Yeah.
Should we go for a walk down to the beach?
I'm gonna compare the beach here. So in 3 days' time, the beach in Australia. Who's gonna win? Hands up if you think this
you know
beach
what?
Is better.
I think you'll be pleasantly surprised. Also, can we talk about how Diane has literally become a meme on the internet with her
hands
up if thing?
I love that.
Anything I tweet nowadays, it's always just replied with hands up if. Hands up if you don't agree with this. Hands up if you agree with this post. Hands up if you think this, that, and the other.
The time has come.
Say goodbye to
Red. Oh, these doors.
You're gonna miss it.
Yeah.
Diane actually thought it really suited me.
Yeah, I think it suits you.
Well, I'm not allowed to keep it. You'll find out why. I'm doing something pretty cool tomorrow morning, which involves a little bit of acting. Something that's very, very exciting. But yeah, so I've got to get rid of this. Otherwise it ages the content. That's what they said. But we've got this stuff down here. I feel like one of the girls. I feel like having like a pamper night.
Here come the girls.
Look.
I'll try these first, you know. Yeah, that's the one to go first.
Yeah, that's what we're going to do first.
I would even put this in
your own hair.
Leave it for a bit in your hair.
Okay.
So that it can really, really take it out.
I didn't know you were a triplet. I didn't know you were a triplet.
What do you mean?
I didn't know you were a triplet.
Oh, what? Because we've got like, one here.
Yeah, and then here. And half of one over there.
We're all triplets. We're a triplets holiday. Imagine if we were all triplets. I would love that. I'd play so many pranks.
Oh, yeah.
Joe would be like, Diane, why can't you dance today? It's not really Diane, yeah, is it?
It's not Diane, it's me.
Oh, lead me through it, Joe.
What would you
never danced before?
What would you call your other triplet?
Americus would be my other triplet, and Lara.
Don't look.
I haven't got pants on. Oh, no, I'll get it on my.
Great.
Diane, Leanne, and Joanne.
Which one's the nicest one? Diane.
Duh, Diane.
You've got to get a temp, you've got to get this working.
What the hell is that? A teardrop.
Right, we need this thing, right?
Yep, get that out. Get your microphone out.
Oh, that's quite a lot.
Is it? Oh, what? Very hot.
Do you remember when you scolded my scout?
Yeah, oops.
Keep your head over.
That's right. How do I open the
plug? I feel like you should leave it because then you can see all the red coming out. Look.
Yeah, I know.
Oh my god.
How red is that?
Get this scrubby dub dub.
And even though I've done it so many times.
That's
yeah.
What happens to me every day of my life.
Ruins my bath mat.
I honestly haven't ever seen anyone keep red hair as well as you do though.
I know, I'm pretty good.
You're a pro at red hair.
I'm dedicated to my red hair.
I'm saying, give it a year, there'll be a L'Oreal Diane Buswell red hair dye that comes out. That's like the best one ever.
Yeah, I reckon.
So you reckon leave this in for a bit?
I'm gonna do one shampoo.
So
I feel like I'm shampooing my baby.
Or a dog.
Well, yeah, or a dog. More a dog. Oh, look at that redness. Coming out.
Love cool. It.
How do we open up the bath? Look, we're running a bath at the same time.
Oh, you just push down on it. It's like a flappy one.
Yeah.
Yeah, push down on one side. No, on one side.
It's definitely not a flappy one.
It definitely is.
I'm telling you now, it's not a flappy one.
Okay, how much do you want to bet?
Oh, yeah, you just push it down.
14 quid.
Oh.
I am going to ask that 14
no.
quid, Zoe.
No, Joe, it does.
I'm telling you now, look.
It does.
Doesn't.
It's
clearly
just,
doesn't.
It's stuck. It's stuck.
You should have said, I bet you I'll be able to colour your hair red. Have you had red hair, Zoe?
I think I went like brownie red.
Back in the long fringe days.
Yeah, back in my long fringe days.
Oh, so nice. Is it out?
I may have told Joe a few porcupine lies. about this red. Yeah, it'll be out in one wash.
Zoe, I'm telling you now, look.
I promise it's you, stuck. It's just stuck. You have to, if you had like full on muscles, you'd be able to.
I do that though.
Look, it's even come out of the house. Sorry, Treehouse.
I reckon give this a little try.
Adam did say, or Stuart, he did say that don't worry about ruining the towels. Just saying, guys.
It is slowly coming out, Joe.
But I think this would be the plug hole.
I personally would really worry about that other one, because that would turn your hair quite blonde, unless you want blonde. Unless you want it blonder, you can use that other stuff.
Oh, it looks like blonde.
It'll actually make it a bit blonde, the colour remover stuff. Remember when you first met me, Joe, how bright my hair was?
No.
What red hair dye do you use?
I use, actually just the Live. Just the packets alive. I actually used that on Joe's as well.
Ah.
But because Joe's hair wasn't blonde, it doesn't go as red.
I wonder if you've inspired anyone to go full on red.
I wonder. Hands up.
Hands up.
If I've inspired anyone to go red, I will tell them don't do it.
This shampoo.
Joe, look at me.
This shampoo smells like, quite nice. Oh, here we go.
Oh, that's actually, yeah, there's some red coming off of that. It's never coming out.
What are we supposed to do? You told me 8 washes, stuff will come out.
You told me eight washes.
I've had about 12.
I also told you that I had a daughter. And that I used to be on Home and Away.
It was very convincing.
Good liar, people.
Is your name even actually Diane? You call yourself Diane because you dye your hair so much.
Exactly.
Your actual name's Anne. Imagine that.
Really sticks, doesn't it?
Diane.
You might have to use the colour stripper, Joe.
Yeah, I think you're gonna have to go for the paint stripper.
For the paint stripper.
Yeah.
So I have mixed this wrong many times and made.
Oh my god! Here we go.
Now I would probably need someone to proofread because.
Do you want me to?
I don't have much faith in this at all.
Sorry, I'll read the box. You follow the thing. Okay.
This is exactly how I imagined.
Skin tolerance test. Nah.
This time I'm going to take. Nah, no time for that.
Okay, pop on the giant gloves.
Yeah.
They are giant gloves. Look at the size of your thumb in those gloves.
No, that will fit perfectly for my thumb.
Look at the size of your thumb in that glove.
Boom, see? Takes up all the room.
This is exactly how I imagined
my
relaxing
like
getaway doing this with my hair. With these two.
Do you know who has thumbs like me?
Who?
I think it is Lara Croft. I mean,
Lara Croft.
What is that really famous girl? She's beautiful. Angelina Jolie.
Oh, no, you're thinking of Megan Fox.
Megan Fox.
Megan?
Google it, and my thumbs and her thumbs. Oh my god, sisters!
Yeah.
Sisters.
Yeah, this is not how I imagine my... If you asked me 3 months ago, Joe, one day you'll end up in a treehouse with Diane and your sister trying to get red out of your hair, I would have said, who's Diane Buswell, to be honest? And who's my sister? But here we are.
Bye, Red.
Bye, Red. Been fun. It has been fun, actually. It's been stressful, but also, oh, it stinks.
Do you wish you never said you'd do this now?
No, I don't regret anything in life.
Oh, what a lovely
thing. You only regret the things in life you didn't do.
Exactly.
And Diane told me that she's a really good hairdresser and that it would be set, I'll be completely fine in her hands. Yeah. And it would probably at maximum take 8 washes to come out. So,
and here we are.
If there's 2 things I've learned, yes, Diane is quite
I think I said 2 washes actually.
If there's 2 things I've learned, so yes, Diane is quite a good hairdresser.
You said to me,
but she's also a liar.
If on the Sunday, if I want to go back to my natural hair colour, will I be able to? I said, yeah, of course.
Exactly. I've just noticed. These socks! Look at them! What are those?
Alfie bought me these.
Oh, they're grippy.
Yeah.
Oh, I love grippy ones.
Diane's got the socks you gave her.
Can we just take a moment? If you're going to shout me out about my socks, what are those?
Do you know what?
I'll tell you what. Comfort is the very enemy of fashion.
Nothing beats barefoot Buswell.
That? Vivian Westwood said
barefoot Buswell.
Vivian Westwood said that.
Did she?
She said, fashion is the enemy of comfort, is the enemy of fashion. It was written above the textiles door in school, remember?
Yeah, I think I did. You never did textiles.
I did.
Textiles?
No, I made a pillow with a penguin on the front.
Oh, I feel like I can already tell that this is coming out.
Yeah, it's gonna be cool.
I want to actually go blonde or silver. I should have silver hair, I think it'd suit me.
I think it actually would, like in your fringe. Like when JB had silver fringe.
Yeah, Jared Barnes.
Yeah, who's that?
My friend.
Oh. I was like, is that a celebrity?
I thought you were just saying it in an accent.
Really?
Jared Barnes.
Jared Barnes. Shout out to Jared Barnes. You'll see this now and be like, what the hell, that's so random.
Do you ever mimic Diane's accent?
Yeah, he does a little bit. Set it going. Or not.
He's, I told you, he can't hear you when he's doing something else.
Remember, I have this bottle in my hair.
Do his eyebrows while you're at it.
Your hair right now. You don't want to be nasty to me.
Yeah, I'm never nasty to you. Shut up.
That'll get edited out. You're not allowed to get it cold. You have to stay warm.
Yeah, you have to continue.
Sit by the fire.
For an hour.
He can't hear a word you're saying.
Right, we've gone for a little walk. Do you know, Diane? There's a troll that lives underneath this bridge.
C5O thumb, I smell the blood of an Englishman.
Jimmy's played poo stick.
Be he alive, I'll get his brains and kill him alive.
Nice.
Have you ever heard that before?
Yeah. Beach walk. We're off to the beach. Perfect day for a walk to the beach. Isn't it, kiddies?
Yes.
I was going to go out in my Timberland boots. I decided to switch up a little bit. And I've stolen Alfie's wellies. He said I could have them. And he's definitely going to regret it at some point. What have you found now?
That's so cool.
You're like a Labrador.
You could decorate that with little lights.
You're like Gandalf.
That is wicked.
Shout, do not, shout, you shall not pass. Shout, you shall not pass.
You shall not pass. You shall not come anywhere or I will show you.
Throw it in the water.
Make a wish.
Yeah, make a wish. Nice, Diane. That's countryside vandalism.
No.
You can get done for that. Oh, people are playing golf in the rain. It's madness. Here we go, Chewton Bunny Nature Reverse. Look, Diane, snakes. You're gonna feel right at home.
That is actually a slow worm.
Oh.
How boring, you English people. It's a slow worm.
We don't get snakes.
It's scary. At home, I'm gonna take one for you.
All right, I'll tell you what is scary though. This, whatever this is. Step in that one.
Look at that.
Oh my word.
That's hard.
All right, into the woods, trying to find ET. Well. We've made it to the beach.
Looks just like home.
So nice, isn't it? It's just like Perth.
Just like Perth.
Now it's blustering a gale. My hands are frozen. But we're on holiday, so it's nice. Alfie, you're enjoying yourself, aren't you? Yeah. Well, we made it. Look how beautiful it is. Isn't that right, Diane?
Yeah.
Diane goes, I love these gumboots. You don't slip in them. 2 seconds later,
Look,
you slip straight onto your arse. Well, this is what a UK beach looks like.
Yeah, I don't like it.
Zoe's gone. Oh, right. We're back from our walk. Dad's still got a wet arse.
Yeah, look at
it.
Look like a drowned rat.
You look a drowned rat. This coat was green once. Look, now it's
got a wet bum as
basically
well.
Black.
Put my jeans on.
I am soaked. Well, not soaked. This coat's very, very good. Swedish made. The Swedes don't mess around when it comes to coat making.
You're
going to change my pants. Oh, yeah. Change your pants. Change your pants. We've come back now to the treehouse. Gonna have a hot chocolate. I'm gonna try and fix my camera by the look of it because it's not looking good. And then heading off for a massage. This really is a proper relaxing weekend. Do you know what? I'm quite happy getting a hot tub again though, to be honest. Ta-da! I've got to also show you the finished product of the hair. It's pretty much out. You reckon one more wash, right?
I reckon one more. Like at the sides, it's like out. Like here, it's all gone.
Yeah.
It's just clinging on just a little bit up here, but hardly.
Let's ask the supposed hairdresser.
I think it looks good. I like the tinge of.
Looks like
why
a
am
purple
I wait,
rinse.
Why am I waiting for the. Oh, back at the treehouse now. If you couldn't tell already, we are back at the treehouse. Gonna order some food. We've still got more champagne lying around.
We're gonna bring play a bottle every. Game.
Oh, you wanna play more games?
Yeah, we need to play.
No.
Hot seat. Yeah. We need to play hot seat. I think you'll enjoy
and
that. But also, we need to watch Alfie. Do his crazy set. What the hell are you doing?
Also, aren't you?
You just got it. Must have got it in the back of your vlog. I was like, I just dropped the donuts everywhere.
No.
None of you noticed.
Oh, I have a 5 second rule. Gives you the excuse to eat all the donuts.
Are you doing a time lapse?
You're doing a time lapse yourself playing the game.
Alright.
No, that's cool. Crack on.
Are you going to teach us to do one dance move?
Oh, do you want us to teach you how to do a dance?
What dance move? What? First, we're going to pick a dance.
Yeah.
And then a move. I would go with.
So we could get you an outfit to do salsa. Salsa's quite easy.
Salsa. Oh, my hips don't move, bro.
No, but we can get a move in. Neither do mine.
Yeah, we could do a bit of salsa.
Should we try and get you both to do salsa?
No, let's not do salsa.
Let's do salsa, then we can put on
salsa or cha-cha.
Salsa tune.
Huh?
What's the one? Dance.
Oh, the Charleston. The Charleston swivel.
We were like, what? Do that again?
Don't worry, I'll teach you guys.
Oh, no, Alfie, try and do a Charleston swivel right now.
I don't even know what it is.
Go on.
All I saw is your foot going in front and behind.
Yeah? Go on.
Well, I don't know what the move is.
I don't know how to teach it. Dan, you're the teacher.
Come on.
No, Joe, I want to see how
Zoe, stand up.
I want to see how much I've taught you on your ballroom hold. Can you teach?
Yes, Joe.
You, I'll teach Al. Okay, you hold
how to do a ballroom hold.
Joe's going to teach us. Wait, what are you? What
I mean, to be honest, I'm on holiday. So, Joe, no, I'm kidding. I'm kidding.
Now, what you're going to do? I don't know how girl bit does, but
how the girl bit
do,
does.
Alfie, you've
got to
do.
Wait, what dance even is this?
We're first going to do a ballroom hold.
Yeah.
What's that?
We could do a waltz. We could do a little box step.
Oh, we're just not even moving.
Yeah, so
box step. We do a box step. You've got to move.
Do what you think you'd be a ballroom hold.
I love that. I love your teaching skills. Do what you think.
Well, I've never done any. I have no idea.
You're
going to
dance with Zoe. How would you do it? Right, okay.
Oh. I don't have a clue.
Right, I'll show you, right. So that,
right.
That was going up like that, but that shoulder's got to come down. That's it, perfect, like that.
I've taught him well.
On the back.
I've taught him well. That's good.
Are you
good?
Yeah,
that one also up, but then a hand down.
Zoe. Look at Zoe's arm.
That's it. That arm is going up and on top of that.
On top, not underneath. That's on top. That's it. That's
and it. Finger.
Yeah, little finger up.
Little finger
up. That's it. God, you really remember the small details, yeah, haven't you? But what side of the body do you need to be on?
You look through that way. Sorry, that way. That's it.
No. Through. Not all the way. Through the gap. Look at me, Alfie. Look at me. That's it. Perfect position. Great. You might want to hold it.
You might want to hold your hand.
So go into your knees.
That's hold the hand. That's it. Yeah. Get into your knees.
Pretend with this hand. Pretend you're like holding a little budgie in between your hands. Where did you get that analogy from?
Right now, you're missing one big thing, Joe. What side of the body should you be positioned on?
No, that is upright. This arm.
Yeah, poor Zoe.
Yeah,
I feel like
my arm's been dislocated.
I'm confused.
What bit am I missing?
Now, what side of the body does Zoe need to be on?
Zoe needs to be on this side of the body.
Yeah, right boob to right boob.
That's it.
Now, Zoe, put your head to the left. Put your head to the left and arch your back a little bit.
That's it.
Nice.
That's good.
Nice. Good work. All right, now maybe close your feet, Alfie. That's it. That's better. Nice one. Good job. Now, you're going to step.
Get your knees more.
Yeah, get into your knees. You're going to step forward on your right foot. Alfie, forward on your right foot.
You go back, Zoe.
And you go back, Zoe. Now go. See, then you're moving, it all falls apart.
Yeah, look,
forward now, side. Now to the side. Oh. Take your left foot to the side. Close.
And back on your right.
And back on your right foot. No, back on your, sorry, left foot. I get confused with my left and right. Sorry.
Back on your left. Yeah, back on your left. Zoe, you
back
go.
On your left, Zoe. You go forward on your right foot. Yeah, so you. Right foot, Zoe. That's it. Now side. Oh. To the side.
My arm's ache already.
Yeah, how the hell did you?
But the thing is, you hold this camera. I bet you I've forgotten how to do it.
Serious? My shoulders actually really ache.
Like that.
Look at that, Joe.
Just like that, and then I go forward on my right to the side, back on my left.
Oh my God!
Side.
Look at
that. My right to the side, my left to the side, my right to the side.
You're honestly better than when you were doing and it.
Oh, a little sway. That adds so much. A little sway adds so much difference.
And then back, and then we go to a fleckle.
Oh, fleckle, okay.
Fleckle.
And what would be like a normal, like, a wedding dance?
Check.
What kind of dance?
Country trick.
The back up and forward.
I honestly don't know what he's doing. He's leading me. He's really good. If you were at a wedding, you could do this, but probably not in this hole.
Right, try
is
like
that,
a...
Is that like a standard, like, a wedding dance then? Like,
well, a waltz. Your wedding dance is a waltz, normally.
What was that?
That was a waltz.
Oh, that was a waltz.
That's a waltz.
Let's do, you try and do salsa. Yeah. I think you'd be quite good at salsa.
Oh, salsa.
I generally think you'd be good, right? Hold each other's hands. Just hold each other's hands.
You're going to go back on your right foot, close your feet. Forward on your left foot.
Right, what am I doing?
You're just going like this. Right forward on your left. Back to the middle.
And
back
close.
On your right. Then to the middle. So imagine
close.
You're in the middle.
When I go forward on my left,
close.
Yeah.
What hip am I doing?
You want to keep your nose over back. Your toes. You want to keep your weight over the
forward
front. So you go
close.
Forward.
Back and close.
Then back.
Forward and close.
Back. Forward. And the smaller your steps are better. You have to do big steps.
You
have to do big steps either.
Like
this.
Really small hands.
By the way, just letting you know, I didn't learn that. What Joe's taught me earlier.
Well, that's because I'm not a teacher.
My steps are going to be like a lunge for Zoe.
Yeah, no, yeah.
See, Diane, doesn't this make it seem like I was actually a pleasure to teach?
Wait, are we meant to hold hands like this?
Yeah, hold hands. Come this side. Like this. Yeah, so you're going to hold me like there and there. That's it.
Actually, it might make sense if you two dance together and I'll do it with Zoe.
We go like this.
Start with.
Forward, I get my left and right, whatever that is. Forward and close. Back and close. Forward and close.
Wait, Zoe, come here.
Back and close. That's it, that's good. Oh, that's good.
Three, two, one. Forward and back.
Come on.
Forward and back. Give
her
a
turn. Lady, give her a turn. Oh, no, it got away.
You
want to
do that?
No.
Why?
You have to go.
Now leave
me with this one, you go
back,
that way.
Really?
Yeah.
Back.
You can do that, Al.
What?
Do what?
I can't do that.
Then do
I can't.
One,
I don't do that. Jacob's little son. Do you remember that arm?
What's the Charleston one?
I want to see you put your, do your hips.
Yeah, but I can't do that. You have to learn
You
that.
Can. No, you don't.
It's like a figure of eight.
It's like figure of eight, like that.
Figure of eight.
It's called a cucaracha. See if you can do that.
Yeah, that's it now. Number eight.
But keep your top half still.
I'm too robotic.
It kind of hurts. Cha-cha.
Yeah, cha-cha you would find hard, would you?
What's more of like a...
Cha-cha-cha. Walk, cha-cha-cha. I don't know, I can't remember how to do cha-cha. That was quite a while ago.
Walk.
How do you... Diane, you're supposed to be teaching... You're the teacher, not me.
Cha-cha-cha. Two walks.
Walk,
step, lock it behind,
wait,
and then step again. Step,
wait,
lock. Yeah.
Wait.
Now on that foot, push off it
step.
And step again. That's
the
it.
Same foot.
Yeah, that's it.
Oh my god, that's hard.
But don't walk on your toe.
Yeah.
Walk on your toe. Walk on your toe. Step, cross behind, and go again. That's it.
That's just how you walk. Just letting you know.
Walk. Step, lock, step. And then you go again, walk.
But then I'm like stuck like this now.
That's, Alfie is so much like me, making excuses for everything. Yeah, but then I'm doing this, so I
make so many excuses.
Okay, right, so walk. Wait.
Take
which
really,
leg
really small steps
with?
As well. You don't need to walk like that. Okay. So if you walk, you literally walk like that, that far. Walk, step, lock behind step. And again, walk, now you're going to do left foot, left, cross behind.
Oh, look at us all
so
like.
Yeah,
that's how I'm going to get around from now.
Yeah, that's how you're going to get around. Da, da, da.
Yeah. Cha, cha, cha. What was the other one you used to do sideways? It was sideways one, wasn't there? It's like side.
The New Yorker.
No, I can't remember. The New Yorker. Do you reckon they could do a New Yorker? No. Even I couldn't do it. Charleston swivel. I wonder if you could do a Charleston swivel.
I don't think I can.
Yeah, we've got
my
that.
Hand-eye coordination.
It's like, no, but I couldn't do it. It's like, you just go, but, like that.
They could do this one.
But. Is that what I mean? Is that it? I don't know.
No,
is
that's
that
it. That's good. Okay, good. Wait, how do you start?
So you start by going your right foot forward and go, but, like that.
Yeah.
Then as you bring this one forward, you twist it that way, but. That's it. That's
then
it.
Go backwards.
Then backwards.
Back, so it's forward.
That's it.
Forward,
oh, that's not bad, Alfie. That's almost it.
Wait, so
that's
it. Oh, I'm so confused. To go one and two, backwards, and then back again. So you always forward, tap, back,
I see.
Tap. Forward, tap, back, tap. Forward, tap, back, and tap. That's it. Now there, now back. Good. Now do it again. Tap.
Oh, then you actually go behind.
Then forward, yeah. Always changing. That's it. Almost.
It's not bad, it's like but that's exactly how I started though, you learn it. It's like learn to juggle.
Yeah, oh wow, you've got a nice foot.
Wait, why did I get this?
You don't have that, Joe.
I can't do the last bit.
Zoe's got a nice foot. Right, so one,
and two.
That's it.
And back again, and forward. It's actually better, easier if you do it quick.
I don't think I can do it.
That's kind of it.
What was the way? Maybe do that first.
Yeah.
So go on one foot, swivel one foot like that. Out and in. Now just add a tap forward and back. That's it. Forward and back.
We'll get used to it.
My balance is really bad.
That's exactly what I said. Remember, my balance is bad.
I'm from the Sugg family.
It does, doesn't it?
Yep. Forward and back. That's it. Forward and back. Now just step on it and then do the other leg.
Yeah, you're getting it. That is literally it. You're getting it. Alfie's getting well into it now, look.
Do this first. Yeah.
Do what I was doing first.
Right,
he's got it. Hey, 4 tens.
Love it.
And there you go. That's your dance class.
Thank you. Masterclass.
75 quid, please. for that lesson. That was almost an hour lesson long. See, now you appreciate what we had to go through.
I don't think I would have learnt much more if it was an hour long.
It's difficult, isn't it? It's hard. Oh, dancing. Right. When's dinner coming? I'm starving. We've had this mystery gift arrive from the place we're staying at. The tree houses at Chewton Glen.
It's like opening the Christmas tree box it all over again, isn't it?
Yeah, shake it. Just don't smash any of these glasses that are precariously placed all around it.
Precariously?
Hey, wait, you have to have a guess what it is. I reckon it's a...
I think some sort of game.
Yeah. I'm going to go with... It's something that we can all partake in, definitely. It's been wrapped quite quick. I can see it's been wrapped in haste. So it's something that we maybe have mentioned in either in a vlog or mentions recently. I'm gonna go with a game. It's definitely a game. It's a disco light.
Oh my god,
it's a disco light.
That is so cool. It's karaoke. Amazing.
Oh my god, it's Kazza.
That is so cool.
Sick. I'm so good at Kazza.
No, you're not. We found out the other day. No, you are not.
She's straight in.
God! So cool. What's your favourite song? Go.
Yeah, what's your go-to karaoke song, Alfie?
I don't know.
Sorry?
I quite like Whitney Houston. Wait, wanna dance with somebody. What did I sing
the other night? No, you guys just made me do The Great Showman the other night and I did not want to do it and I got thrown into it.
Oh, bull.
Sorry.
That's what they say, yeah.
Rewrite the stars.
That's what they
I like.
Say.
Mine is currently Summer of 69 by...
Is it? Summer of 69?
Brian Adams.
Mine's the Joanne song.
Send my love to Joanne. We should sing that.
Yeah, do you reckon it's on there?
That's cool.
I reckon it might be because it's a very popular song.
Which means it's wireless.
It's in the charts.
Which means that someone else can probably hack into it and play the any song they want for it. Dun dun.
What is one thing about me that sounds like bullshit, but it's actually 100% true? I'm singing on the newest Band-Aid song with One Direction and Ed Sheeran. I won one man of the match in a rugby game. I have slight webbed toes. It's definitely not true. I played rugby. Interesting round.
I think I know which one you put.
I know which one. I think man of the match.
I think webbed toes you've put.
I think man of the match.
Both got it right.
Yeah.
Oh, I got webbed toes, so I get 3 points.
God. Alfie gets 3, dying.
Can we just say the best one, though, is the fact that I wrote?
What did you write?
That you're on the newest Band-Aid song with One Direction.
I played rugby. You?
What do you mean you're on the newest Band-Aid song?
The newest Band-Aid song, we're singing on it.
What's the Band-Aid song?
Feed the world.
It's called putting my pointing. And little finger in my bottom at the same time.
Okay.
Going on a safari. Doing a fart in front of Joe so he doesn't feel left out. Or shark diving.
But you definitely bluffed on that one.
You go first, Alfie. I think I know you what I'm said saying. Doing a fart in front of Joe.
I think you said safari.
Okay.
I think you said shark diving.
Oh, you're good! Oh,
no!
I thought you were double bluffing!
Yeah.
I get a point, I put a safari.
And I get a point, I put a fart in front of Joe.
This means that you've all written stupid answers. Everyone's filming with me.
Not necessarily. Diane's not filming you.
$100 that no one else in this room would do for $1,000.
There's a lot of things.
Try my own piss. I'll come back.
I've literally
read 2 words and I'll come back. In my hands and clap. Put my balls between my legs and call myself. Put my balls between my legs and call myself Sharon. Bungee jump.
I'm gonna go bungee jump. I'm gonna go try my own piss.
Try my own piss.
Oh!
Oh my god, guys, I just got 4 points.
Oh.
Did
they guess you?
Yeah.
Oh.
Why did I change my answer?
Damn it.
Yeah, my original one.
I was balls. Yeah. I was Sharon balls.
What am I in the top 1% of? Indonesian, year 9.
What?
Honestly.
People with tiny thumbs. The Small Thumbs Organization. Pro dancers that got all the way to the final strictly and failed miserably.
Oh, holy sh**. Someone was in.
I don't know. You gotta go first.
I'm gonna guess Indonesian, year 9. can't imagine either of these who wrote that.
I think I may also go for Indonesian year 9.
Honestly.
Did you read the card right?
I was in the top 1%.
Indonesian year 9. I might have to go for that one as well.
Wait, what? What does it mean?
What, speaking Indonesian?
I was good at Indonesian. In year 9.
Oh my god.
Did you put a small thumbs up?
Yeah.
We've got a karaoke ball here tonight, and we're going to sing some karaoke for you. So sit back, relax, and enjoy the show. First up is my colleague Diane. Shall we sing? What are you singing tonight, Diane?
I don't know any songs.
What's my go-to karaoke song?
What's my go-to?
This one.
Oh yeah, you know this.
You know this one.
First I was big, I was petrified.
You were strong. Get back. From outer space.
I love that you've not moved a muscle. I love that Diane hasn't moved a muscle.
Okay, Diane, congratulations, that applause is Diane. The first time the carriers have been on our first program, so we're singing about the strangers.
Big one for Diane.
Big song, Diane. Can you take it? Here we go.
What is it?
No pressure, I'm giving you easy ones.
Summer.
Love is an open door. Love is an open door. Love is an open door for you.
With you.
With you.
With you.
What is this from? Frozen?
You're joking, mate.
Frozen.
Frozen.
Oh.
Oh my god, I love it.
Have you ever seen it?
Open door. Love is an open door. Love is an open door.
With you.
With you.
With you.
Will you marry me?
Oh, it's that proposal.
Oh no, that was all planned.
Right, and after all that singing song in, it's time to go to bed. So I'm gonna say goodnight. Goodnight. Goodnight, everyone.
Goodnight.
Good night, Diane. I hope you enjoyed today's vlog. If you did, give it a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel if you haven't already, and I will see you very, very soon with another one. Remember, I'm not a daily vlogmaniac. Good night.